Every company has large amount of data. Like insurance companies will have data about their policyholders and will have data about their customer, will have data about their customers, their claims, premiums, everything. Even normal retail stores or the departmental stores will have data about their customers and the suppliers. So there's a large amount of data in the market. What we'll do, primarily we look into this data, analyze the data and try to extract some meaningful information, some meaningful insights from the data. How will we extract these meaningful insights? We'll use some statistical techniques. And where will we use these statistical techniques? On statistical softwares. Now, what are these softwares? There are many softwares available in the market, like R, SAS, SQL, Excel, Minitab, MATLAB. Now, some softwares are free, some software are licensed. R is a free software. What we'll use, R is a free software. It is a user-friendly software. It is an open source. Everybody and anybody across the world can develop it. Now, everything we try to do in R, we'll need to write codes. For the first, whatever codes, for the first few classes, we learn the syntaxes, how to write codes in R. Then we'll move on to data manipulation, statistical inference, and finally, what information we do get from the data, depending on a syllabus like stochastic processes, Markov chains. We'll use a lot of modeling also on R. So firstly, do not try not to miss R classes, because everything is interlinked in R. Now, how to download R in your PC? Go to Google. And write download R. The first link which appears, click on that and click on this first link. Automatically an exe file will download in your PC. Open that file and keep on clicking next. Since it's installed in my folder, I'm not doing it again. After it is installed, go to all programs and search your scroll bar to R. You will see an R folder created. Open any of the two. You can open any of the two in your PC. The R interface looks somewhat like this. This is called the R interface. It looks like this. Now, R works like a calculator for us. If I write anything, even if I write 1 plus 1, I press enter, it gives me 2. If I write 5 minus 2 and I press enter, it gives me 2. If I write 7 divided by 3, it press enter, gives me the answer. So anything I write in R, it works exactly like a calculator. But suppose I want to go and change my first line. I want to change it to 1 plus 10. How would I do it? I would use my up arrow keys. And see, as I press, the previous commands keep on appearing, and I write 10 and I press enter. But if I have hundreds or thousands of code, will I use these up arrow keys to navigate through my codes? No, it is very difficult. So there are two limitations to this screen. Firstly, we cannot navigate through our codes easily. And secondly, we cannot save this page. So what we do, we'll go to file and we'll open a new script. This is a new script. And this new script is exactly word-like structure. It's a notepad-like structure where we write anything and it will give me the same results. So if I write 1 plus 1, I press enter. I write 5 minus 2 and I write the same codes. But can you see, by pressing enter, there's no answer. There's no answer whatsoever. I'm not getting any answer. So how do I get my answers? How do I execute these codes? You have to execute these codes by pressing Ctrl plus R. You have to press Ctrl and R together. What is the shortcut? Ctrl R. That is the run code. Now can you see this cursor has moved to the next line? So if you have codes in the next line, and by pressing Ctrl plus R, the cursor automatically comes to the next line, but only if you have codes in the next line. If you do not have code, it will remain in the same line. And I just, whatever line I need to run the code, I have to just stay, put my cursor on that line, and it will run the code that way. Is this clear? So from now on, we'll refer this as our input window and this as our output window. Whatever input we are giving, we'll input it in this file, and whatever output, we'll get it in this file. Now we can save this file to overcome our limitations of this site. We can save this file, but it will be saved as an R file. Now R file will open only if your computer has R installed in it. What I prefer is, or what the institute also prefers is, what we do, we'll press Ctrl A, which selects all the code, we'll copy it in a Word file or a notepad file and save it, so that it remains intact and you do not have to worry about your codes, because Word or notepad will always be there in your computer. Now tell me, can we run these all three codes at the same time? Can I run multiple codes at the same time? Yes, I can do that. If I select all these codes and I press Ctrl plus R, all three codes get run at the same time. Or suppose if I have to run, firstly R follows BODMAS rule. So if I write, this, R will follow the BODMAS rule. So if I run this code, I will get the answer. If I want only a part of my code to run, so what will I do? I'll just select 1 plus 1, I press Ctrl, I'll get 2. So I can also run a part of my code. Now suppose if this was in the next line, suppose this was there, will this work? Yes, this will work. R is very smart. So if you press Ctrl R, see, I'm getting a plus here. That means R knows that there's something missing in this line, and I have to go to the next line to find it. Again I press Ctrl plus R, again R knows that there's an operator, so there will be something. And if I press Ctrl plus R, I get an answer. I could have run this entire code together by selecting everything together. Okay. Now if I have to clear my output window, since it is so full, how do I clear my output window? I have to clear my output window by pressing Ctrl plus L. Ctrl plus L will clear my output window. Is that okay? Now let's be familiar with Excel. This is an Excel sheet, as everyone knows. Now how do we put data in Excel? We put data in Excel as name. Age and gender, and this is how we put data in Excel. Suppose this is the data. So whatever data I'm putting down in Excel, I'm putting it down vertically. This is row column wise, right? The data is column wise, but this does not happen in R. We always assign data, we get in horizontal vectors. So how do we assign data in R? So we write A equals to 5, or A arrow 5. That means I'm inserting a value into R. That means this means, and don't put a straight arrow, this arrow won't work. Only this, don't put this sign, this won't work, this will give you an error. We'll only use this sign. This is A assigned a value, A being assigned a value of 5. I press Ctrl R, and if I write A again, I press Ctrl R, see, A has a value stored of 5. So anytime I want to find what is my A, I can write A and run it, and I get to know that A has a value of 5. Now suppose I want to change the value of a. If I want to change the value of a, it's very easy. I just write a equal to 6 and a gets overwritten. And a, suppose, sorry, I'm very sorry. A, and I press control again, I run a. A gets overwritten. So a has a value of 6 now. This is as easy as this. Now suppose I want to put values from 1 to 5. Consecutively, I want to put values from 1 to 5 in my data. How do I get it? So it is, I will write b of 1 colon 5. If I write this b of 1 colon 5, I will get data from 1 to 5. See, now if I run b here, see, it has data 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So if you have consecutive values, if you have consecutive numbers, then you can put colon instead of writing the entire 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. But suppose if I have random values like 1, 3, 6, 7, how do I insert those values? So to insert those values, you'll use a function called concatenate. It is denoted by C. C of 1, 3, 6, 7. If I write this and press Ctrl R and I run D, see, D has a value of 1, 3, 6, 7. So for entering random values, for entering non-consecutive values, we'll use C, that is concatenate. C stands for concatenate. Now if I have to write text, in R, how do I write text in R? Suppose I have to write a name. So I'll use this function. Text should always be in double quotes. If text is not in double quotes, R will not understand what I am giving it. If R will give me an error. So text should always be in double quotes. If I press Ctrl R and if I run E, so E has a value Gunjan stored in it. Similarly, if I have to assign three different values to three different names, so how will I assign? I will write C of any three names. Do it and press Ctrl R. Now if I run F again, it gives me all three names. Okay. Also, if I have to add, suppose to D I had to add one more value. How would I do it? I would have just run D equals to C of D comma, suppose a value of 8 I have to add. So this, and now you run D again. So 1, 3, 6, 7, 8. So D has an extra value. Using C and the array set before, you can add values to the array or the vector. Now tell me what, now let us know what are the properties. Now okay, we can see that D is a numeric, D has a numeric class of properties. D is a numeric set. So how do I know when I'm working with a large data set, how will I know that which array will has which type of data? I do not know. So there's a function called class, and class will help me to find which array will have which type of property. So if I write class of D, see, it gives me numeric because D has all the numeric values. Similarly, if I write class of F, if it will give me character, it is text, everything. Now character means what? Alphanumeric. If I write Gunjan 1 2 3, it can be just special characters, it can be just text. So all these come into the categories of character. So there's also another class in R which is called factors. Now what are factors? Factors are categorical variables. Now factors are basically, they are data objects which are used to categorize the data and store it as levels. We'll see that. Suppose these are three arrays. These are three arrays which I have named. This one is name, one is age, and one is gender, and I run these three. I run all of these three together. Now I have to find the class. I have to find the class. So I write class of name. Now R is case sensitive. So if I have name end with small letters, I will write here name as small letters. I cannot write it as capital because R is very, very case sensitive. It will not identify if I write it as capital. Okay, so if class of name, it gives me character. Similarly, class of age, it gives you numeric. And what is class of gender? It is giving me character. Okay, first now let see, now name, age, gender, here it's coming in arrays. What is the similar structure? The similar structure to us is working like this, something like this. It should be in a table format. So how do I get a table format in structure in R? By using a function called dataframe. I use a function called dataframe. So what is the function? data.frame, if you write, and you write the just the name of your array or the columns which you have assigned, which is name, age, and gender, and give your table a name. Suppose I give my table the name as data. I'm giving the table name as data. The name, age, gender, and I press Ctrl R. This, and now you run data. Now is this structure similar to everybody? This structure is very similar to us because it's a table format. Now if you have to find the properties of our columns, what will we use? Now since everything here is in table format, now we'll not use class, we'll use structure. Okay, so if we write structure, we'll use str, and I'll write my table name. See, I will get the properties of all my columns. So what do I get? Can you see? I'm getting name as factor, age as numeric, and gender as factor. When I run here, class of name I was getting character, age was numeric, and class gender was again character. But here it has turned into factors. Now what does factors mean? I told you factor means categorical variables which are stored as levels. Can you see factor with 10 levels? 10 levels means, so there are 10 unique values here. With 2 levels because there are only 2 unique values here. Okay. So if I don't want R, if I don't want R to convert it into factors, I don't want into factors, I only want it as to remain it as character. What should I do? When this by default R is doing it as into factors, but I don't want R to do it. So if I'll write strings as factors equals to false. I'll write this strings as factors equals to false, and this should be written as it is because I told you R is case sensitive. If there's one error, R will not run. The code will not run. It will give you an error. So I press this. Now if you do structure of data, see I'm getting character, numeric, character. So I'm telling R not to do its default function. That means I'm telling R not to convert my data to factors. I'm telling strings as factors equals to false. If I would have written true, or if I have not written anything, it would have given me this answer. Okay. Now forming for a data frame, the way I formed here, it was very easy. Just use the function data.frame and writing name, age, gender. But the main criteria for this is all the three arrays should have the same number of elements. If there's different number of elements, data.frame will not work. All three arrays should have the same number of elements. Okay. Now suppose let's come to filtering. Now suppose I have a large data set and I want only a few columns of it. I want only one or two columns of it. How will I do? What will I do? So suppose I write my data name is data, and we'll use a square brackets. Okay. We'll use a square brackets, and the right hand side of my square brackets will work only for columns, and the left hand sides will work only for rows. the right hand side of my square brackets will work only for columns and the left hand side will work only for rows. This is there. Then, so if I tell you that I want only the first two columns of my data, what will I write? I will write here 1:2 and data is my table name and I want only the first two columns of my data. If I press Ctrl, see, I get only the first two columns of my data. This is how we do. If I tell you that I want only the name and the gender column, see, when I'm listen to my questions very carefully, when I'm telling you the first two columns, that means I know the column numbers, so I'm writing 1:2. And when I'm telling you the name and gender, that means that time I do not know what are my column names, what are my column numbers. So that time I will write data comma, I want all the rows, and I want, since I want both name and gender, I will write name comma gender. I will write this C. I'll use a C because I want two ambiguous rows. They're not together. Okay. I will control name and gender. This is the way I'll get it. So you should be very focused on what your questions ask you to do. If you do not know that what is your question or what is your, if you do not know what is your row number, what is your column number, you cannot filter like this. Okay. So if when I have to work only with rows, I will work with the left hand side. If I have to work only with columns, I'll work with the right hand side. This is the, now suppose I have to get the top, I have to get the top 5 rows of my data. So how will I do? I will write data and I need the first 5 rows. So I'll write 1:5 and I'll need all the columns. So I need the top 5 rows of my data and I get only the first 5 rows of my data. Similarly for the last 5 similarly for the last 5 rows also, but last 5 rows is difficult if you do not know the entire row number. So R has a default function called head in it. R has a default function called head in it, where head will store, if you write head of your data name, it will give you, by default it will give you the first 6 rows. So if I write head of data and press Ctrl R, see, by default it will give me the first 6 rows. And if I write tail of data, by default it will give me the bottom 6 rows. Okay, now suppose if I want, as I was telling you, if I want the bottom 5 rows, and but I do not, if I do not know what, where, what is the last row number of my data, I cannot write it in this function. Now this is more easier. How will I do? I'll write tail of data 5 data comma 5 and it will give me the last 5 rows. So I can customize this head and tail. I can customize it. Similarly for this also, if I want to top 4 rows, I can write head of data comma 4. This is the way we'll use head and tail function. Now when we filter data, here, what do we filter? When we filter data in Excel, what do we filter? We always filter the rows. See, I filter, and I filter by female. What gets lessened up? My rows are lessened up. So whatever, always what gets filtered, my row gets filtered. So here also, my, whenever there's a filtering question, whenever you are asked to filter data, whenever you ask a condition on data, always your row will get filtered. So we'll always work on the row side. If I tell you, give me all age greater than 25 from the data. If I tell you, give me all age greater than 25 from the data, how will I do? So I will write data, which is my table name. And age greater than 25, that means all my ages are stored in rows. So I will work on the row side. How will I indicate that I need to get work in the age column? How do I indicate R that I need to work on my age column? So we write data dollar age. This is the way we indicate our rows, indicate our columns. That is, on the data table, go to the age column. This is how we do referencing. This is the same way we do referencing in Excel. Similar kind of way, here also dollar signs are used for referencing. Here I am telling my R that in the data table, go to the age column. For data dollar age, and I want all age greater than 25. So I'll write data dollar age greater than 25, and I want all the columns. So I'll write this and see, I get all the ages greater than 25. This is how I work in this. Now suppose I have condition. I have a condition that I want all the data of the females with age greater than 25. If I have all data of females with age greater than 25, so I will write data dollar age greater than 25. And since there's an and condition that all females with age greater than 25, I'll use an ampersand sign. Ampersand sign stands for and function, and I'll write data dollar gender equals to female. Will this work? No, this will not work, because R wants something extra. R will always want something extra. So here we'll put a double equals to. Double equals to work as a logical operator. That means this equals to, it should be exactly equal to female, then only will this work. Okay, data dollar gender equals to female, and I put a comma, and I want all the columns, so I'll write all the columns, and I'll press Ctrl R. See, with age greater than 25 and all the females. Okay, so this is how an and condition works in R. So what are the logical operators? Less than will work like this, greater than will work like this, greater than equals to, less than equals to, equals to will work as double equals to, and how will not equals to work? With an exclamation sign and a not equal and an equal to sign. This is not equals to. So if I want all data not equals to females, so I will write data comma data dollar gender not equals to female, and I press this, I press a comma, and I press this. So I'll get all the males. Okay, now suppose I want to work within a range. How will I write? I will write data of data dollar, I want age between a range, age less than equals to, I want age greater than equals to 25, and I will write data dollar age less than equals to 40. This is an AND condition. I want my age range between 25 and 40. So I'll write data dollar age greater than equals to, and data dollar age less than equals to 40, and I want all the columns. So I'll not write anything on the column sign, and I'll get all the column, all the ages between 25 and 40. Okay, this is I work with AND conditions. Now if I want to work with OR conditions, if I tell you I want either the data of all people greater than age 35 and or I want all the females, so how will I do? So I will write data of data dollar age greater than equals to 30, or is this sign in your keyboard, just see it's above the backslash, it's in the backslash key. You have to press shift and get press the backslash key, you'll get this sign. And I want or data dollar gender equals to females. I want this data. So if I press enter, see, I get people with age greater than equals to 30, or I get the females. This is how an or condition works. Is this okay? Now remember, in the industry we are not generally data inputters. We will not generally input data. We'll always import data. We'll always get data from somewhere, and we have to import that data. We'll always get data from somewhere, and we'll have to import that data to R. How to do that? How do we do that? So first we need to assign a working directory to R. As working directory means, we'll have to tell R in which folder is our file stored. So how do we do that? We'll use a function called setwd, which is called set working directory, and put double colon. We'll put double quotes, and inside it you will put a path. You will go to the folder in which you have your files. You will go to this bar, select it, see the path gets selected, and press Ctrl C and press Ctrl V here. So your path gets pasted. Now wherever there is a single black slash, wherever, since I have only single command here, if there are 2-3 single backslashes, please replace all the backslashes with a double backslash. Please replace all the backslashes with a double backslash in your command, because as I told you, R is free and R will every time need anything extra. Okay, and if you run this code, so now this is set as a working directory. Now R knows that I have to find files inside this folder, but how will R know which file to open? We have to specify the file name. So in my folder, my R file is stored as CSV format, that is comma separated for values. You will generally get all your data in a CSV format which you have to import. So since my file name is R1 and R2, how do I import those? We'll write read. First we'll give them a name. I'm giving them A, and I write read.csv, and you write r1.csv. okay, this is the way you read it, and press Ctrl R. Similarly B, and I write read.csv, and second file name is r2.csv. These are my two files, and I press Ctrl R. Now run A and B. See, these are the two tables which I have imported. This is the way we'll import data in R. This is the way we'll import data in R. Understood? First we'll set a working directory. The first step is setting the working directory. Second step is you will see the way in which your file is saved. Since my file was saved in the properties, if I see, you can see comma separated values dot csv. So I wrote read.csv and r1.csv, and we read.csv r2.csv. Now let's see these two files. This is one table. This is another table. What I have to do is, I have to merge these two tables. How will I merge these two tables? Firstly, what does the merge concept require? The merge concept requires that two tables should have a common ID, common key between them. There should be a common key between them to join, to for merging of the table. Because otherwise, how will we know that for this data, for this name, this is the age, this is gender, this is the location? There has to be a systematic way in which we merge the tables. So here also there are two tables and I need to merge them. So in Excel, how do we do it? We use a VLOOKUP function. We write equals to VLOOKUP. And what do I have to look up? I have to look up ID. In which table I have to look up? We need a table array, and the table array is this. This is the table array in which I look up. And I need the column index number. Since I need the age over here, so I'll write 2. And I need the exact match, so I'll write 0. And I see, I get 27 here. And if I copy paste, see, can you see there's an NA here? Because see, can you see the last is not the same? So there's an NA here. Similarly, if I had to write the gender, same way I would have done it is, I would have fixed this column, and pressed enter, and I would have copied this formula and pasted it here. width, and now I need the third column, so I need the gender also. And this is a merge table. This is age and this is gender. This is a merge table of my data. I do not have to go and copy paste or do anything. I just had to put one function and this table got merged. Similarly, how in R it gets merged, R also in R it will get merged with the common key. So for R, this merge function, you just have to write merge and my table's name. This is A comma B. It's control R, and can you see it got only merged till China. From here, if you see, it got only merged till China here also. It did not merge Nepal. Similarly, in R also here, it did not merge Nepal because those they did not have a common ID between them. So it will not merge. But now suppose I close this file and I open it after a week back, and I just see this code, I do not run the output. How will I know that by which column did my table got merged? So we should always specify our key column, which is by equals to ID, and it should be as it is your column name, otherwise it will not run. So since I have put ID in both in capitals, so here also both in capitals, R is case sensitive, I am telling you continuously. So A comma B by equals to ID, and I press control and give me the same result. Okay, now suppose I want all the data of my first table. Suppose I want all the data of my first table. So how will I do? I will write merge. I will write X equals to A, Y equals to B, by equals to ID, since I'm using ID, and I'll use all dot X equals to true. Why all dot x equals to, since I need all the columns of my, all the rows of my first table, I do not wish to eliminate all the rows of my first table, so I need all the rows of my first. So I'll write all right x equals to true, and this has to be right, x equals to a, y equals to b. There cannot be any other syntax in it. Even if we have three tables, we'll not introduce z, we'll do the first two and then we'll continue with the third, with the merge table. So all dot x again, I press control R. Can you see now I got a Nepal also, H N E 1 H Nepal N A N A. There's an NA in the last two columns because table 2 does not have the data of the age and gender of H N E 1. Okay, similarly, if I had to get all the values of the second table, I would have written all dot y equals to true, and I would have got the data of H N E 2, where age and gender, and I don't have name and location of my HNE2, so I will not get it. If I had to get all the rows of both the tables, if I don't have to miss anything, I will write all equals to true. I will write all equals to true, and see, I will get all the data, HNE1 also and HNE2 also. And if I just want the merged columns, I will write merge of A comma B by equals to ID. That's all for today. That was the first class.